Alrighty, welcome to another Vintage Cube here on ChannelFireball.com. This cube, of course, is brought to you by Ultimate Guard, sponsor of Team CFB. We're testing out new strats here with a little the dog cam. So Julie will be making an appearance for some part of it at least. And much like her, I'm unimpressed with this pack. And what's the best card in this pack? Probably Tundra, to be honest. I mean, Ebon Death Dracolich is not a card I strive to put in my deck in general. There's Wasteland, which is fine. Looting can be good in the right decks. So can Spellseeker or Treasure Cruise, but it's just safe to take Tundra. Hey, what's up, JS2? Hope you've been winning. But yeah, I'll take a Tundra here. Not like a thrilling first pick, but hey, a blue-white duel? Not a bad first pick either. It's below average, but not by a lot. Probably pretty close to average first pick, right? What do we got second here? We've got a Verdant Catacombs, which doesn't really go with the first pick too well. Hey, what's up, Vodre? That's a 30 months. Welcome back, Vodre. You're always here on stream. I appreciate you hanging out. There's Spell Pierce, Chart of Course. Those are both fine. Recruiter of the Guard is not something I want a second pick. Ancient Tomb is pretty good. I might just take Tomb. Tomb is good. Solid Stipulation Draft. We draft all the cards from the most recent set release. No, that's a really bad stipulation. And at least that's my opinion. The reason is the stipulations that remove all your choices aren't interesting. It's not interesting. You have to take a land out of every pack. I don't find those to be an interesting draft experience. The stipulations I find more interesting are like, you can't attack. So that changes the value of a lot of your cards. If the stip is you can't attack, or you must win by decking, or, you know, whatever it is. And I think that's cool. I don't think that in draft you're just forced to take a certain card or like that fun. So that's my opinion on stips anyway. But I'm going to take Ancient too. Maybe end up in an artifact deck or something like that. Watery Grave is fine. It's also Kaldra Complete, but that's a Stoneforge thing. Armageddon is okay. I think I might just take Preordain. Preordain is such a safe pick. Smuggler's Copter is good too, but I think I like Preordain. Let me know if the sound is low for anyone else, but it shouldn't be. Things haven't changed, so. All right. Let me just take Preordain here. What do we have here? This one's pretty medium. Ooh, I do like Loyal Warhound. That's like a kind of interesting one. Because if you're on the draw, or if you have like a Mox or something, I guess you'd have to be on the draw end of a Mox, but in any case, just getting to play this to go get a land is pretty sweet. Like, that's an actual strong effect. There's also Plateau. Unfortunately, it's basic, so you can't get a Tundra, but I think Plateau's pretty good. Because these decks can be blown. I'll try Loyal Warhound. Look, I'll throw the dog a bone, as it were. So I'll take that. And then, an easy remand. Especially it's old frame, too. Everything's lining up perfectly here. What about this? This pack. Now it's getting a little tricky. Because the best card in the pack, I think, is probably Emrakul, the Aeon's Torrent, or Toxic Daedalus. Those are the two best cards. Hey, what up, Jisayupa? Thanks for the support. I appreciate using your Prime sub on me. Everyone else is, of course, welcome to do so. Neither of those cards go that well with what I have. I mean, Toxic Deluge actually goes okay with this because it's just a good card, but it doesn't go great. I think I'm just going to take the Emrakul. Yeah, it makes me wish I took Plateau over Loyal Warhound. It'd be a lot happier, but it's got such high upside when it works. So, well, here we don't have anything that goes with Emrakul. There's Mind's Desire, but I don't find that's not really looking good with what we have right now. Hey, what's up, Bastion, with the 10-month Resoberino? Might just take Fallen Shinobi to go with that Loyal Warhound. Mostly I'd be interested in Fallen Shinobi because it's just the most powerful card in the pack. I don't think Relic Warder, Sculler, Mind's Desire. Yeah, none of these cards really stand out. It's, again, speculative, but we'll just kind of see where things go, right? Here maybe a Fatal Push if I go in the Fallen Shinobi direction. I don't like Sword of Body and Mind in particular. Hey, Stunlock with the 47. Welcome back, Stunlock. Thanks for the thoughtful gift on the Baby Registry as well. Don't really want Spectral Procession here. This is such a bad Signet. So bad with what we have. Hey, what's up, Draligo? Welcome. I think I'll just take Fatal Push. I don't know. Well, now there's Nahiri. Nahiri is actually good with Emrakul. I do like Thraben and Spectre a lot too, especially with Fallen Shinobi. It's going to be one of those two. I like Wasteland. I'm kind of surprised the Wasteland Wield, because this pack wasn't that strong, but you know, here it is. So what's better? I mean, Inspector is good with Shinobi. That is like a real thing. Nahiri is just a good card, though. I'm just going to take Nahiri, I guess. It's close, though. I guess I'll take Recruiter now. I don't think I'm a past in Flames gamer here. Okay, Inspiring Vantage. Oh, there's also Smuggler's Copter. I kind of wish I took the Inspector, actually, the way this is working out. Because right now, Smuggler's Copter goes nicely with like all the cheap creatures. Yeah, I'm going to take the Copter. It's also good with Ancient Tomb. Well, I guess I will take Show and Tell. Yeah. All right, well, I'll take Legionnaire. That's fine. Yeah, it ended up better. Thraven Inspector actually would have been better than Nahiri, given the next couple picks. But we've got this kind of like Emrakul thing. We've got a Fallen Shinobi plus a Fatal Push. And we've got two good blue cards, a blue-white land, and three good white cards. So we've got a bunch of stuff. Hey, what's up, Eric? It was great seeing you, Eric. I saw your text, but obviously I'm in the middle of a draft, so that's more important. You have to understand there's Vintage Cube and Eric, but that's, you know, that's still pretty high. You're definitely above AFR draft in terms of, like, priorities. But no, it was great seeing you last weekend. That was really cool. Andrew, the thing is, Makeshift Mannequin I find to be pretty weak. I just don't think it's good even in a Reanimator deck. I have not found it to be good, at least. So I don't really prioritize it. Not that Show and Tell is all that either. Show and Tell is also kind of bad, but... all right, I'll keep the Tidehollow Sculler. If I end up being like Esper value creatures, which is actually a deck I think can be good. Sculler is good there. Hey, what up, Super Cavitation? Welcome back. And I appreciate it. Thanks for watching all the content. You know, folks watching my content lets me do more content. That's kind of how it works. Oh man, Christoph, I've played Wingspan before and got trounced, so I'm not the one to ask. Hey, what's up, Minionad? All right. I mean, I guess I'll put that there for now. Yeah, missing out on a Thraven Inspector is unfortunate, but it's not the end of the world, honestly. So, not too bad. Yeah, they left out, the cube changes this time around were a little baffling to me. Like, I do get that AFR cards get a pass, and honestly, the Modern Horizons 2 cards have been awesome. Like, I don't actually have any complaints about MH2 cards because I think that those tend to be pretty good. But the AFR cards are mostly busts, but even that, like, a lot of the cards that I like Nykthos that are still in, it's just like, Nykthos, but like, why Nykthos? Oh, I'm glad you've been liking Storybook Brawl White Falcon. I have two. Circle of Dreams Druid's pretty sweet, obviously for mono green. So for us, there's Ponder, Resto, Moldrifter, and Solemn. Oh, I love all the old frames. That I do like. I think that's excellent. So it's also Jace. There's like a bunch of blue and white cheap cards. I'm going to take one of them for sure. Resto's nice with Ancient Tomb, but you know what? Resto wheels a lot of the time. Not that many decks actually want to play Resto. Exactly, Keith. I don't think Resto is the highest priority. I might just take Ponder. The cantrips are just so strong. Getting past a Mock Sapphire. Well, there we are. I'm really glad I took Ponder then, because those are a nice combo. All right. Mock Sapphire and probably not wheel anything we care about, but I will take it. Also, Mocks. Ramp with like high leverage cards like Fallen Shinobi is just so good. Obviously, it's just like unbelievable. Is Jace not great with Recruiter? No. The main thing is like recruiting for a Jace is just too slow, basically. I didn't open power. It's true, Sponzy. It's true. Yeah, Danilo, I mean, you can enjoy games without ever playing them. Like, there are games I've watched much more of than I've actually played. Like, I've played a lot of Battlegrounds, but I've watched more Battlegrounds than I've played, you know? No, Molly, I didn't open the power. It's still complaint equity if you didn't open the power, right? At least that's how I think it works. That is my understanding. Yes, Gabby has watched above 99% Storybook Brawl and obviously likes the game quite a bit. What do we got here? What do we got? Dark Slick Shores would be solid. I'm not taking Twin. I like the addition of Dragon's Rage Channel. I think that's cool. I think I've got to take Mother of Runes, right? It's so good. It's such a powerful card. So yeah, we'll take that. We'll see where that goes. Yes, James, this week's CR, Constructed Resources, which I believe we're recording, well, it's today or tomorrow, but probably tomorrow, will in fact cover standard for the Arena Open. That is our plan. Since, did you know, chat, there is an Arena Open this weekend. It's hidden. No one talks about it, but it is in fact there. Arid Mesa is a blue-white duel. That's pretty good. Yeah, we're going to try to cover Historic Jumpstart as well. Yes. No, no jokes. There's Arena Open this weekend. It's standard for some reason because they don't like money, but yeah. You can literally win $2,000. I'm going to play in it. Like, I don't know. Might as well. Yes. No, no, not even lying. Yes, that's the thing. It's standard, so. All right. Well, Bribery is good, and I have Mox Sapphire and Tundra, so I don't think Bribery would be outrageous. There's also Arid Mesa, which is kind of what I'm looking at because, first of all, it can go get this Tundra, so it's a blue-white duel. Also, if I do end up wanting to play Nahiri, which isn't out of the question, yeah, I'm going to take this. This deck's not looking like a high curve one. This is not an impulse deck. I would play impulse on the deck, but it's not a deck that needs impulse because these decks aren't really looking to fit two-card combos unless I end up in like the Emerald Cool direction anyway. Don't want Brain Freeze. Power Word Kill. Yeah, sure. Probably just take Path. Path isn't amazing, but it's fine, and I'm not really interested in playing any of these other cards. I don't think. I'm not that impressed with Revelark in general. Yes. Of all these formats you could have picked, and you picked Standard. Yeah, I'll try Invoicing Wizard for that, Gabby. We'll see how that goes. It's just so weird, you know? Is Power Word Kill better or worse than Go for a Threat? I would have to look at the makeup of creatures in the set. I don't know. My guess is it's probably a little bit better, but maybe it's worse. I don't know. I mean, who knows? Eldraine being in Standard is really ridiculous, yes. It is truly and utterly ridiculous. Yeah, there are a few dragons for sure. If you're playing the Standard qualifier, I think that this would probably be a good idea to play the Open this weekend, assuming you have time, because they're going to be the same format. Good practice. All right, do we want Flicker Wisp here? Well, first let's laugh at the inclusion of Flame Spill, but now that we've got that out of our system, do we want Flicker Wisp here or Sword of Feast and Famine? Flicker Wisp, Blinks, Loyal Warhound, Recruit of the Guard, Tidehollow Sculler. I'm probably in for Flicker Wisp. I think Sword is a little slow, and I just don't like the Swords that much. I don't know. I'm in for that. And then now, oh, I could still sneak. It's actually not outrageous to sneak. Oh, just, you know, your normal, like, blue-white, white weenie with sneak attack. Also, sneak Flicker Wisp. Sneak Recruiter. Recruiter for Flicker Wisp is decent. Otherwise, I'd be taking Seasoned Hallowblade. No, we're gonna be a hero. We took an Arid Mesa, so therefore, this is very reasonable. Oh, perfect. Look, now we can take Shodan of the Scalds and have the, you know, this just the classic Porcelain Legionnaire into Show and Tell curve. I love it. I don't know what to play, Christopher. You could just pick literally any good standard deck and you would be fine. So, yeah, we don't have the red mana for Pyromancer, but we'll take that. And then now Resto did wheel. I think we're probably going to try to take out black. We don't even have any black fixing. So that part isn't necessary. Let's see. Ninjutsu Emrakul, yeah. Yeah, I mean, Resto still looks good, I think. Like, Resto still does kind of the things that I want it to do. Yeah, I'm in for Resto. Taiga's a little bit far, but you honestly never know. Let's just do that. Oh yeah, Sculler's gone too. Good call. Now do I want Elspeth, Sun's Champion, Scrap Heap, Scrounger? Probably just Elspeth. There's also Frost Titan, which I guess you could sneak in. Yeah, maybe the Frost Titan is like fine. I'm probably not going to play any of those cards. This actually could be a not terrible Dreadheart Arcanist deck. We have three spells already. Yeah, that's a good amount. I'll just take the red card. I can't pick Flamespill, just on general principle. Oh, we wield the Seasoned Hallowblade anyway, so no big deal. It's just White Weenie with the good high end. that's all. So here we've got to make the decision between Prismatic Vista and Mana Lake. I think you could probably tell that Prismatic Vista is where we want to be, given that we're playing three colors here. And we're going to tap out a decent amount. Plus, we have a Remand already. All right. Vista it is. Alonis Cryptozoologist, huh? All right. I do like Force of Will. We have four blue cards right now. Okay, or maybe not. Paladin class, I don't know, about all that. Oh yeah, Julie is loving it. Phantasmal Image. I mean, if I pick up like just a couple more blue cards, Force Will becomes quite good. Force Will is so good in these kinds of decks. I think I'm just going to spec here and just hope to pick up a few blue cards over the course of the draft. This actually could be a real Skull Clamp deck. We've got a couple one toughness creatures. You know what? Plus, if we Skull Clamp up an Arcanist and attack for two, now we're talking. All right, now we just need a Stoneforge Mystic here. How high is Prismatic Vista on our pick order? It's very high. It's better than any of the fetch lands, pick one, pack one, I think, and or duels. So it's just really good. Urza's Saga. Urza's Saga can get a Stoneforge, or sorry, a Skull Clamp or a Mock Sapphire, plus it's just a really good card. Yeah, I think Urza's Saga is actually the thing I want here. Seven Deadly Sins. Welcome back with the 32 months. Oh, our cube is being sweet right now. This Force Will is not getting there, but I could take Looter. What the Looter will do is it makes the deck a little more consistent and gives me a Force of Will pitch, plus it's good with Skull Clamp. There's also Chrome Mox, but I've got Sapphire and Tomb. I think I'm doing okay on that. Lightning Bolt is actually really good with Dreadhorde Arcanist. Yeah, it's going to be actually pretty hard to pass up on Lightning Bolt given the circumstances. I'm not taking Vamp. Oh, this is actually a good Thirst deck, I think. I've got a bunch of artifacts. I've got a little bit of card draw. I've got the Force here. Bam. Hey, what's up, Sazra? Oh, the first World Magic Cup? Yeah, yeah. That was a fun one. That was the war we got bonfired, actually. Yeah, this deck is a Scalding Tarn. I like Dig and all that, but Scalding Tarn is obviously just... And Shark Typhoon's good, too, but yeah, we're taking Scalding Tarn. This deck, look, we've got Preordain and Ponder and Thirst to kind of hold the room together. Hey, what's up, Pavlo, with the 3-month reset. Welcome back. Yeah, I would definitely play Tide Taker if it wheeled here. This Emrakul has opened up some possibilities, let's just put it that way. This is 29, 23 with 6 lands, so yeah, we're actually doing pretty good on playables. Because we can probably play 17 land plus a Sapphire with Saga counting as like a spell, kind of, if we want to. What was the stipulation here? Look, so here's the thing. Mother of Runes can help protect Emrakul from things. Actually, can't protect it from too much because they can't protect it from the colorless stuff. But, no, this doesn't look... This looks like a sideboard Linvala here more than anything else. Yeah, I don't think we're not going to play black. I don't think there's a reason to do that. So, it can protect from, yeah, Sower of Temptation, O-Ring, sure. I mean, it makes Show and Tell a little bit better. Hey, what's up? Take two from Bigram. 136 damage, is that what's going on? There, yeah, nice. Yeah, I mean, I might Show and Tell here, especially when I have the Mother of Runes to protect the Emrakul. That's just like extra backup. Oh, I love Ren and Six, but I don't think that's what I'm supposed to do. It's also Lyra, but Lyra is like kind of weak. Let's just take Grim. Grim is solid. I know I have the Taiga, but that's still just not enough to... I mean, we have, what, 3 fetches? I guess we have the Urza Saga. Maybe I should have taken it. I don't know. Take Needle Spires though. I think that's decent. Maybe I should have taken Ren and Six, but the thing is I'm not even gonna be playing main red here, so who knows. When I watch Battlegrounds, who do I like to watch? Dog is by far my favorite Battlegrounds streamer. I used to watch Dog every morning when I was like pretty into Battlegrounds. I like Show as well. And then my late night pick is Wumbo Style. I think he's awesome. He's from Australia and he does some cool stuff for sure. The whole shirt thing is great, Kep. I love it. In Dog's stream, they have all this like weird copypasta. It's just a meme about him taking his shirt off, which is just like, it's just really funny to watch. Hafu has been streaming Battlegrounds too. I'm sure she's excellent. I actually loved watching Hafu's Among Us streams. I even played in their lobby a few times. That was really cool when they let me do that. But I haven't caught her Battlegrounds stream because I haven't been into Battlegrounds since she started streaming it, but I'm sure she's great. Oh, she's very good at games. So, yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Guess I'll take that. Yeah, I'm not surprised that Hafu's great. She's just so good at games, you know. It's also pretty cool. It was just cool seeing all those folks like 5UP and Hafu really blow up. I mean, Hafu was already very popular. She was already huge, but like even more so because of Among Us, it was a really cool, like just getting to kind of see that take off was cool. I remember when, I remember retweeting or tweeting out one of 5UP's YouTube vids when he had 2,000 Twitter followers. Now he has like 250,000 Twitter followers. So it's like cool seeing that happen in like right in front of your eyes, you know. I'll take Figure over Godless Shrine. I'm just not playing the black cards here. Mm-hmm. That's funny, Dokumo. Yeah, you had copied one of Dog's decks there. Should I have taken Ren 6? I'm actually kind of rethinking it. Yeah, Among Us was a lot of fun. I just kind of got to the point where I didn't want to play anymore, but I did have an incredible amount of fun. Like, if you look at the amount of, like, fun I had, like, total, right? If you were able to quantify the fun times the amount of times I played or many hours playing, Among Us has to crack my top five games. But would I be willing to play in the next PogChamps? Well, it would depend what the format was or what the game was. But obviously, if I was invited to a cool tournament, I would play in the cool tournament. We probably shouldn't have taken the Ren and Six, but this is quite the deck. All right, well, let's do this. Oh, Vidal Corbin, I'm glad you liked Brawl. I'm going to be playing some more of that here. All right, I mean, we have enough cards. I don't see anything on the sideboard I really want, so. I know this is a Wrath, but I'm not really in the market for a Wrath here, so. We probably can get away, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 red. Well, let's see how we're doing on the other colors, see if we can afford it here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9 white, and then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 blue. No, we probably can't afford that because I want another blue because I've got the blue cantrips to help me fix here. Do we want Mother of Runes? I think Mother of Runes is fine here. There's nothing I really want to play instead. I don't think I'm supposed to play Omnath. Oh, Figure of Destiny? Yeah, I think Figures. I guess I have a lot of islands. Never mind. No, Figures get a little bit rough on the islands. After all, let's see. If I played a Taiga, it would have to be over one of these other lands, probably an island, and then I'd have, what, two ways of fetching Taiga? After all, why shouldn't I play Omnath? Yeah, no. It's probably good. Omnath is another blue card for Force of Will. So plus you can sneak Omnath in. Oh yeah, this is perfect. We kind of got there. Well, Linvala doesn't hurt me anyway. It's mostly is it good against your opponent? And I would say main deck Linvala is probably not good against your opponent most of the time. Oh yeah, Urza Saga is fixing to Omnath too. Sure, yeah. No, this is all makes sense. In fact, we're probably being, like, it would be greedy not to play Omnath when you have such a powerful card sitting in your sideboard here. Look, all we have to do is draw, like, the Sneak plus the Emrakul, or the Mother of Runes plus the Seasoned Hallowblade, or the Dreadheart Arcanist plus the Ponder, or the Omnath plus the lands to cast it, and then we're fine. Oh, I love that meme, Trex, that like, after all, why shouldn't I keep this ring, you know? I say that a lot. Mostly when I'm like buying XP spells in Storybook Brawl when I've just lost my last three fights. I'm like, after all, why shouldn't I level myself up? Well, that's the thing. We have Ponder and Preordain. We can just kind of like sculpt our hand the way we want it, right? Isn't that right, Julie? She's not paying attention to me. Oh, I do always buy the pig in Brawl. The prized pig is like one of my biggest leaks. After all, why shouldn't I buy the prized pig? Oh yeah, if I played against someone and they went like turn one Mother of Runes, turn two Hallowblade, turn three Thirst, discarding like Omnath and Emrakul, I'd be like, oh yeah, sure, you can, those are all legal. Oh, now you're doing great, so it's right. Is it a leak if it's correct? Well, here's the thing. I bought prized pig with Gwen the other day and immediately used the knighthood on the prized pig. And I sent it to Gabby Beak. I'm like, oh yeah, you know, we're pig gamers now. And then like 10 minutes later, we got seventh. Nothing we can do about it though. Unavoidable. Oh yeah, no, yeah. Baby's starting kindergarten soon, and I don't know who's more nervous, you know, me or her. Yeah, nothing we can do as the usual. All right, I'm really excited for our opening hands here. Yeah, I mean, show and telling an Omneth, like, after all. I actually think Pig is good in Storybook Brawl. I also believe I buy it too often. Both those things can be true. Oh, I've heard that story Mold of Five. Yeah, when Peter Jackson was directing Christopher Lee, who literally like was, you know, has been in like active battlegrounds, like has fought in wars, and was like, no, that's not the sound someone getting stabbed makes. Uh-oh, Mox Pearl. I don't like doing that. Oh, we're doing great, Mark. October is the date. Little sequencing error. I don't know if you can spot it. Their turn one play better be good to make this make sense. Nope. Nope. I mean, I'm gonna lose here because they now have library here. But yeah, that could have been worse. Okay, if they don't have something, oh no, hand disruption. Well, what are they gonna do? Yeah, good luck. I have all my bases covered. Yeah, and we're max punishing them by doing nothing. Do. They took the sneak. Good. That wasn't even what I wanted. Isn't what I wanted. All right, let's go. Let's go. Okay, land. Not Emrakul's, please. All right. I mean, not drawing a land is bad. We're gonna be in a little bit of trouble here. I got that song from a Hercules stuck in my head. Nissa. Ooh, and then they keep seven cards in hand. Bless my soul, Herc is on a roll. All right, come on, land. There we go. Now, how could this go wrong? That's the question. How could this go wrong? Like, what could they possibly have that is a plan? Yeah, the music. I mean, I've never watched the movie, Justin, but Gabby showed me that that song. And oh, they can't metamorph my Omnath. That is something worth noting. All right, but I can crew and slam. Yeah, let's discard the Legionnaire. They didn't even think about blocking. I mean, Smuggler's Copter is not the end of the world here. Like them putting in Metamorph, it could be a lot worse, like way worse. This is probably in like the top 20% of outcomes for me. Oh yeah, crewing Copter with Omnath. That's the business right there. Why couldn't they metamorph the Omnath? Because they were both entering the battlefield at the same time. They do not. You cannot. The metamorph can't see the Omnath, which is like definitely high on the list of like magic rulesy nonsense that really doesn't make intuitive sense when you explain it to someone. But it is how the rules work. Yeah. Oh yeah, Julie couldn't hear the mailman from up here. She's just dubs. No, Julie's right here. You see my. Really? They got nothing? Nothing? Okay. Can I get a fetch land or something? Yeah, we went on a long walk today. The Sponzy didn't want to join me. It was kind of brutal. I could thirst, and the advantage of thirst is if I find a fetch land, I can pop off with Omnath. But I don't know that. But I want to attack with both. I don't want to crew Copter with Omnath. I think I'm just going to play the Dreadhorde Arcanist because this is also going to be good next turn. This I think it's too greedy to thirst. I don't know. Because I get to leave path up two, and now actually think I discard the Plains even though it could cast Flickerisp. I don't know. Feels like all the cards in my hand are pretty good. Thirst can find me a land if I need to. Show and Tell was also plus one mana, not just mana fixing. Plus Dreadhorde Arcanist, having it in play is pretty nice, because next turn I can Thirst into maybe a cantrip, or I can just cast multiple paths. Like, if they go to activate, if they crew copter and go to beginning of combat, I'm probably just going to path it. Like, their hand is obviously not that good, despite having a million cards in it, you know? Mm-hmm. Big Geek, the copter is indeed too good. This card was one of the first bans in Standard after quite a while, and a well-deserved one. I don't like whatever's going on here. Nissa who shakes the world. Okay. Okay. That's fine. How much do I like Greed for Feed and Slay the Spire? I tend to play those games fairly greedily, I will say. So now, I was going to kind of assume they crew, but I guess they're going to play another creature first. Reflector Mage actually got banned, yeah. Reflector Mage, whew, that's a card. That's just, I could go on about how Reflector Mage is like, it hits the triumvirate of like, oh, I'm going to probably have to path that. Too powerful, not fun, and bad design for like memory issues, even outside both the fun and the power level. Really just the triumvirate of like, you should not have done this. They're very close to dead. Dude. Favorite Super Nintendo game? I mean, was Mario 3 Super Nintendo, or is that the original one? Like, I don't know what you classify those two as, but I loved Mario 3. It might be, that's just Nintendo. I don't really know what Super Nintendo games are. Sponzy can probably ask or tell you. Once Upon a Time was also horrendous. Yeah, I'm gonna have to path the Toski because that draws them two cards, I think. And then, because then I get to use Dreadhorde Arcanist to attack and path the forest if I want to. Yeah, we never had a Super Nintendo, me and Sponzy, so that's why I don't really know. Maybe I should have discarded Thirst instead of the Plains, but I don't know. Lightning Bolt would be amazing. Good job, Mole. You have figured out the what I want to draw. Recruiter of the Guard. No, we're going to Thirst here. There's a lot we could draw that would be good. Bolt would obviously be amazing. A fetch land would be pretty good. The best I can do is garbage. Okay. Okay. I'm going to keep Force of Will. Guess I'll discard Taiga and Recruiter here. And then we're going to crew Copter. Who are we crewing the copter with is the question. So if I crew with Arcanist and attack with Omnath, then they can double block. So I think it might be Omnath. So I can attack with those two. And then I can play Path out of my graveyard with the Arcanist on the forest. Just gonna attack them. Yeah, all right. Let's do that. If I draw, I wouldn't mind drawing a blue card here. Okay, I turned too late. I guess I discard the force now because it's just not gonna come down to that. Yeah, if I had the bolt earlier, that obviously would have been good, but this is still pretty good. I could path my own creature to trigger Omnath, but I wouldn't be able to use the mana for anything, so that's not really gonna get me there. Oh. Is this technically correct floating? People love technically correct floating. Or is it something? Yep, nope, technically correct floating. The dream. I could have bolted the Nissa, but I don't think I want to. I'm going to play this even though like I don't need to do that like this turn. I still think it's fine to play it there. I'm hoping they're dead with Copter and Bolt next turn, yes. They do get to flip their Nissa here, which I am going to allow them to do. I mean, they have access to a lot of mana and a lot of cards. I wouldn't Like, I would have felt a lot more confident if I had found a blue card for Force of Will instead. You thought it was better to not cast Thirst, cast Recruiter, and attack with Dreadhorn Omnath and Copter? Yeah, maybe. I don't really care about that too much. They get to put extra counters on their Planeswalkers, but that doesn't really matter. No. Oh, Jules is still down. When was Standard fun for you the last time? Couldn't tell you. I honestly could not answer that question. Have you ever gotten into poker? No, I've played very little poker across my entire lifetime. I watched a decent amount, but I never really got into it. Don't think now is a particularly good time. You can have two Nisses as long as they're different names, yeah. Things look a little worse now that they're demonic tutoring with access to a million mana, but we'll see. What's my big tip for barbecuing? Low and slow. Low and slow. Okay. They're still dead right now. Does Denver have a bad tick problem? Not that I know of. The King John, welcome to the Divination. They really tutored for a Primeval Titan? I did like Rogues. Rogues is relatively fun. But I guess a better question is, like, I've had a lot of games of Standard that are fun over the last 10 years or whatever. At what points in basically the entire existence would I have played Standard over a different format? There's just not that many points, you know. When I cook a brisket, Keith, I prefer to get the internal temp to like 205 or so. They have Copter. That doesn't matter. You can just flick a respite. Right now, they can attack me for 16 down to 1. I guess the Vorinclex puts a lot of counters on the forest. I didn't really think about that. I guess I'm glad I played that land for Omnath. Playing against rogues, yes, is not the most fun. I will grant you that. Okay. I'm at 2. They have only green mana, and unless they have like a Nature's Claim or something, this is probably pretty good. Bzzzt. Bolt you. It would have been tilting if that Mox was a... Oh, they didn't even have the Copter. Well, whatever. Do I want to flicker anything? I guess I could flicker Omnath. Sure. Crew tapping Omnath. Do the Dreadheart Arcanist my bolt. Oh, sure, I'll draw and discard. Boom. Didn't think we were going to win this game, I'll tell you that much. Hey, Scott Pilgrim, welcome back to 21 months. Do. Playing against mono greens, huh? That does make me want Linvala. Yeah. And I do like the bolt and the path. Maybe I could take out Force. And I kind of want to get... Do I want to get Arath in here? I have a lot of 4-mana cards. I could probably put in Wrath and take out Seasoned Hallowblade and just, like, keep... Warhound's a good value card on the draw. Dreadhorde, Copter. Like, all these things work out pretty nicely. This is my only, like, pure aggro card, so I think this might work better. Mm-hmm. Yeah, show and tell Nom nothing turn 4. How could I lose? The draft formats are very good. You know, I guess Porcelain Legionnaire... Sorry, I took... That's the only other beater. But Porcelain Legionnaire, the rate is pretty nice on that. Hey, what's up, Berserker? Welcome back. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I'm glad I sided in the Wrath. I just won't play the Legionnaire probably on turn 2 here. Okay. Hopefully this is something I can Wrath away that won't cause me a bunch of harm before that. Looks like a green Sun Zenith to me, though, or we'll see. Hex Drinker. Oh, okay. Well, that's cool. Because they're going to spend a bunch of time on that, and then I'm gonna Wrath. On the other hand, let's see. Because of 4/4. Yeah, no. I mean, I'm just not going to play the Porcelain Legionnaire. I could Flicker Wisp the Hex Drinker to make them waste more time on it. Who knows? Going all in on Hex Drinker. Okay. Yeah, no, sure. Go for it. Why not? Oh, really? It's kind of weird to, like, do that, but also not do the fourth counter. Do I want to play Flicker Wisp? It's probably fine to do that. Just to make them waste their turn. I've got so many cards in hand. I feel like I should do that rather than do nothing here. Nissa. That is annoying. Okay. Don't like the Nissa. I'm going to take it, but actually, I think this might work out just fine because now I've got Resto. So I'm going to attack Nissa in the air and then pass. And then I've got Resto on Flicker Wisp can be pretty strong here. I could have Resto Flicker Wisp the Nissa out to prevent them from getting double mana, but I don't mind that too much. Okay, if they're going to spend all their mana on Hex Drinker, then I'm like pretty happy about this. Which it looks like they're going to. So now they've got Hex Drinker to 4, Hex Drinker to 6. It's on 8. It gets protection from everything. So what's probably going to happen here is I'm going to let it go up to 7. And then, because they can only level up as a sorcery. So they go up to 7 here. And then when they try to go up to 8, in a shocking twist, I've got something. I guess I should get Taiga here. Resto, the Flicker Wisp. And then Flicker the Hex Drinker again. I drink your milkshake. Because at this point, I'm not actually interested in Wrathing. So we're kind of off that plan. It actually would have worked out better to just cast Porcelain Legionnaire, as it turns out. But this is fine. Also, they can't even really attack with their forests off Nissa because I've got a 3/4. Why don't we wait till their attack? Because it had protection from everything. That would be a terrible play. I prefer not to let my opponents get protection from everything 6/6s. That usually makes my job harder. Let's send. Yes, I agree. You do not know what that card does, which is fine. You don't have to know everything, but. I mean, I might still Wrath, actually. Wrathing. Wait, what happened? Did I not attack it with both? That was a mistake. How did I not attack it with both? I must have just clicked through or something. That was terrible. I attacked them with both? That was definitely not what I intended to do. Wow, no, I'm going to lose now. Huh. Ooh. Okay, let's cast Porcelain Legionnaire, I guess. Okay. We made our life a lot harder here. Damn, yeah, that is unfortunate. Hold on, how do I want to play this? I just was not paying attention. Might be. Let's just do this. Yeah, casting off Tomb and Plains is actually better. No. I don't think playing Wrath when their Nissa's out is actually good. This might be okay. or it might not. Depending what this is. If I can remand here, kill Nissa and then Wrath, it's like not the end of the world. But yes, that was definitely not good. It looks like a finale. Yeah, well, we're going to remand the finale. On a scale of 1, how enjoyable is it to clap back on someone suggesting you make a bad play? It depends on how they said it, you know. I generally think, like, part of my philosophy is that, like, instead of, like, assuming I made a mistake, though I obviously made a huge mistake there. It's not like I'm immune to mistakes. Not saying that. But instead of assuming I made a mistake, like, especially when people ask a little aggressively, which that last person didn't do aggressively, but still, like, maybe like investigate why that would have been happening. I don't know. People just have a very low confidence interval, like needed to claim a streamer makes mistakes. And I see this for a lot of other streamers as well. Like there was a really bad one in Gabby's chat the other day and she snapped him off. It was so good. I loved it. I mean, this is still going to be fine. Like, we're going to get to kill an extra land. So, that part's nice. All right, let's go attack Nissa, and then attack my opponent here. What? Oh, it's a 4-4. Okay, I thought that was a 2-1 still. I was, like, really surprised. Yeah. Let's blow up all the lands and everything, and then Preordain. I don't really want either of these. Let's put these on the bottom. Ooh, nice mother runes. They paved the lives here. Okay. I mean, they have the finale. They might just have to use it here, you know. Hex drinker's back. Back again. Yeah, I'm like, you probably want to like dress me before getting your hex drinker back, but this works out. I mean, the hex drinker, like, now they know not to attack into Nahiri, so that's pretty good for them. Let's go recruiter. Get the loyal doge. I'm at 7. Definitely playing mother runes. Yeah, I'll play the Doge. I'll go to 5 here. It doesn't really change my clock too much. And I couldn't get the extra land off it anyway, so. Oh, yeah. Gabby's call out there was good. All right. So they can make it pro instance and not attack. I mean, I am dead in 2 turns here. Credit where credit's due. Hex Drinkerino is getting there. The thing is, if I don't tomb there, then they can attack as a 4-4 and I'll have to, like, chump. So I think this is okay, but I don't know. I need to find a lightning bolt. No, lightning bolt won't work either. Yeah, there's not that much that actually keeps me alive here. Funnily enough, the hex drinker always gets you in the end. Hey, as needed. Welcome back 4 years, as needed. I'm glad you're hanging out. I appreciate it. They know about the Nahiri from a duress. So that play only works if you think they're a complete moron. I generally don't think my opponents are complete morons unless they've demonstrated they are, and this opponent certainly has not. So I don't think that is the play. All right, we'll see if we can find something here. Do I consider players and D&D opponents? No. Oh, Emrakul. The end's torn. There's not that much that actually... I honestly don't know if I'm drawing to anything here. Because is pro instance right now? Hey, what's up, Hexstar Dragon? Welcome back with the 5 months. Yeah, no, I mean, I don't think I can do anything here. All right. Good beats. I definitely messed that up. It's possible I still lose anyway to a follow-up hex drinker, but obviously I made my life a little bit harder there. Linvala will continue to be good. Yeah, all right. Oh, wait. Let's get this. Hold on. Where did that porcelain legionnaire go? It was tricking me. Let's put Grim Lavamancer in. I think Grim is going to be generally better in this matchup. Next fight is going to be hard. Yeah, to give you a little update on D&D, they went down to the Abyss and they fought their way through like 2 Baelors, then a greater Baelor and some blood demons. Oh, there's actually the goblin like demon grinder, the like war wagon came in and swung the wrecking ball and tried to trample Raptor, and they had some help, though not really that much help. And there's all these like angels and demons fighting all around them. It's like a whole warscape. And they finally get to Grazit, who's like the demon prince, like the demon prince, actually, and like the most notable of them. And in a previous campaign, Grazit, Gabby and Josh McLean and one of the NPCs had pledged their souls to Grazit. They're level 14. Currently, Grazit's also fighting fighting a Solar at the same time, Gabriel. So it's not just straight up toe-to-toe versus the Demon Prince. That actually, that wouldn't be particularly fun. But then out of this portal, Grazit summons Gabby's old character who pledged her soul to Grazit. And then, you know, we're going to see what happens next fight. But this is Gabby's character from a previous campaign. So it was pretty, pretty good stuff. All right, let's play first. Okay. This hand needs something. Like, it needs something. I think I've got a lead on Arid Mesa and Pass, because if I want to play a turn 3 Linvala, which I kind of do, then I need to lead on white as my first two draws, but we'll see. Oh, hello darkness, my old friend. Wow, turn 1 Hex Drinker. Okay, well, this actually might work out, because now they don't know I have Nahiri, and what I'm probably going to do is get Tundra here, play Dreadhorde Arcanist, and then next turn, assuming they pump an attack, I can Nahiri it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's on Tabletop Simulator. Come on, Hex Drink. Drink your milk drink. How lame do I think Hex Drinker is? Nah, Hex Drinker is cool. It's a different angle of attack for a green card. I don't think it's outrageous. Oh. Yes, good, good. A good, a good. Yoink. Yoink. The only thing that's bad is we're not getting any value on the Dreadhorde Arcanist attack here. Really wish I had started with a Ponder, but I also really shouldn't complain. I even drew the Prismatic Vista, so now I have Nahiri if I need to. Tracker's good. Tracker is good. Hope they have Duress. Given they saw Nahiri, is that attack a mistake? It's borderline. I wouldn't say, like, if they didn't attack there, I wouldn't think that they were ghosting, but I also don't think that attack is crazy. Just got an island. Resto, huh? Yeah, the Ancient Tomb, I guess, is the other part of it. So yeah, no, that it would be kind of weird not to attack there, actually, given that information, sure. How much do I care about a Tireless Tracker? It can be a 5-4, maybe. If I play Linvala, it doesn't really interact with that. I think I'm just gonna pass here and leave up Resto. I don't know. The Linvala doesn't really do anything, so Resto opens the door for a few possibilities here. Hey, what's up, Kenny Darko? Welcome. Hey, what's up, Andrea? You watching from bed? Good times. Ciao bene, or something. I don't know if that's even like something you'd say there, but how's it going? It's hard to adjust the doggo cam too much more because she's like right under the desk. It's actually kind of difficult to get too much more here. Yeah, I enjoy using Tabletop Simulator, as some folks are talking about it, for D&D. It is more work, but honestly, I think it's like comes out so nicely that I enjoy it more as a result. You think this is White Weenie? Well, we've got some stuff for you, Andrea. Mengu, there's a... What if I told you this deck has Omnath? Well, you see that. Okay. Also, Emrakul to Aeon's turn. So we got some things. Yes. As I've gotten more used to TTS and better at searching for like pre-made layouts, it's gotten better for sure. Oh, that's awesome, Kenny Darko. I hope you do. Hope it works out. I think I'm just going to do this. And then flicker it. I don't really want to try to block there. Get a planes. Oh yeah, the heist map, that took a long time because that was not a pre-built template. But I think it still was definitely worth it. Like, I've never regretted the time I've spent playing D&D, except for when people cancel like all the time. No, I haven't regretted it at all. It's been too fun. And now I can Nahiri the Tireless Tracker if I want to. And I want to. Kibler is currently playing White Weenie and Cube. It'd be funny if we played him. That would be sweet. It would be nice to draw a cantrip or a taiga or something. what do I do here? I've got to just do this. There's really hard to justify doing anything but that. And then play a land, play this, and then send. Because even if they have Nissa, I have a blocker. So the first thing. Oh yeah, Molly, that's good. The first thing that Gratz, the first campaign I ran for this, the online group here is Princes of the Apocalypse, which honestly I wouldn't really recommend as a campaign. It's the Temple of Elemental Evil remake, and I love the original Temple of Elemental Evil, but I don't think that campaign was great. It was just okay. Then we moved to Waterdeep Adventures. I call it Waterdeep Mysteries, which was a kind of like combination of the Dragon Heist adventure, which is levels 1 through 5, but they were level 11 when they came in, so clearly I'm not just running that straight up, plus a bunch of just homebrew stuff, and it's just kind of developed organically from there, which I find to be the most fun of D&D anyway. So running my own campaign is definitely a lot of fun, and I've had a good time with it. I think the next one, probably I'll lean a little more on source material just because of the time it takes, but it still has been awesome. Oh yeah, Andrea, we've got Dreadhorde in the cube, and it's just okay. I don't think it's great. I would never think it was a mistake to cut it. They got to kill my red here, right? White, blue. I don't think that's as good as killing my red, honestly. Oh, Preordained to go with this Dreadhorde, and then Shodan the Scald and Taiga. Oh, look at this. Would you look at that? Then play Taiga, and then Grim that. Oh yeah, this is the money. I'm not gonna discard Omnath. Let's do this. I'm an 8. Yeah, I can just do this attack. Cast Preordain. Bottom, top, and then yeah, I'm just not gonna discard a card. I was just deciding if I wanted to use it to kill one of their mana, which I might want to. Ooh, said you sent a message, Kenny Darko. I like it. I like it. People tend to make new characters when either they die or when we finished Prince of the Apocalypse. There was some talk of people making new characters, but no one, like, if anyone individually wanted to, but everyone decided to keep their character, and it's fine. That was a good value turn, I would say. But basically, like, part of the thing that is really sweet about D&D is like the open-endedness of it. So like Prince of the Apocalypse was a little bit more on rails than I would have wanted, like Molly said, or Squirrel said, because you kind of just had to, like, there was some intrigue and infiltrating the, like, it was like the four evil elemental cults for a while, but then eventually it was just like, yeah, we got to go to these temples. They actually never went to the Air Temple because they crushed everyone else and then crushed everyone the Air Temple sent at them, so they just never ended up going. But like, it was just, yeah, there was just not as intriguing, whereas the Waterdeep stuff's been, I think, a lot more awesome. I've enjoyed it more, at least. I don't know about how the campaign feels. Oh, yeah, this double black card is just a Wrath of God. It's 2 white-white Wrath. Do I DM with plot armor? No, I mean, I find the 5th edition rules are pretty permissive in terms of damage. Or damage, well, speaking of damage, they're just, like, obscenely dead here. But I'll just finish them off. I think I could probably do like 15 or 20 damage in this turn, because I also got to trigger that and then I got to grim them as well. Yeah, like if someone dies, they die. And in the other campaign we ran, like, Josh McClane's character died like 3 times. He just kept making new characters, you know. Any advice for your cover letter for Direwolf? I don't actually know who's running the hiring right now, Kenny, so I could not tell you that. But I think if you just, you know, address it to, like, you know, hiring manager or to whom it may concern, I think that's fine. I think that the best advice for cover letters is to show why you're passionate about and why you think you'd be a good fit. Honestly, I think cover letters are just kind of bullshit. So there was a while where I was doing the hiring for Direwolf and I just did not care about cover letters. I just don't find them to be interesting for the most part. Like, you don't have to write me an essay about why you want to work here. Like, you're applying to work here. Presumably you want to work here, and your resume should do a good job of showing off kind of like at least why we should talk to you. And most of the time when you talk to someone, like, that's the first step, you know. But But I mean, I'm not saying don't put effort into it. You should, but I don't know. I always found that to be like not a particularly interesting part of it, you know? GG's and Benetus. GG's, if that was you. Squirrel jokes. So let me give you an example, actually. So I did the hiring for CFB also, and when we were hiring a community manager, Squirrel put in like a complete joke application, and we actually would interview him for it because it was really funny. It was actually like the right style of what we were looking for. Obviously, we actually hired someone who was just like 100 times better. Now, Juan is fantastic. Juan is our community manager at CFB, and he's just amazing. A+. I love working with him. I think he does excellent work. But we would have interviewed Squirrel if he actually wanted the job. Like, it was creative. He knew his audience. That was an advantage as well, you know? No problem, Kenny. I'm sure you'll give yourself your best shot, so... Oops. That's a good start. I mean, that's not a bad start. Let's go Copterino, and then next turn. I mean, we got a real white weenie start. Bolt into Copter into Hallowblade plus Mother of Runes. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Juan is so good, isn't he? Isn't he, Mango? He is awesome. Yeah, I can't speak to every work experience, of course. I can only speak to the couple places I've been involved. Let's see, what are they going to mana crypt out next? Okay. That's like solid, but not as scary. The first turn was very scary. Ooh, and a Skull Clamp. All right, let's play this one because if we draw a Dreadhorde Arcanist, we would rather play the Arcanist off of the copter here. don't mind me just discarding Emrakul's to my Smuggler's Copter. Meanwhile, I have 7 power on the board on turn 3, but CC Morpho, so mi papá nació en Chile y mi familia está de ahí. El mitad de mi familia, por lo menos, y mi mamá viene de Minnesota. Yes, I like the metal giving a medal here. That was good too. Ooh, Circle of Dreams Druid. Okay, their plays have gotten progressively less impressive. Not like a knock on them, but it's just not that good here. Oh. Okay. Let's see. I'm just deciding, I guess that playing the Nahiri doesn't really do much for me, but I don't really need Mother of Runes either here, so I definitely do not speak Portuguese now. Let's attack with these two, let's draw. This is tough. I can't really... I can't discard Arid Mesa, so I can rule that out, because then I couldn't cast Preordain. At that point, I'd really rather just cast Preordain. I could discard Skull Clamp. I could discard Nahiri. I could discard Preordain. Depends what I want to do here. I think I'm just going to discard Preordain and cast Nahiri here is my guess. I don't know. They're at 8. It's not like Nahiri does much this turn, but it's my most expensive play. And it's just plus 2. And then this gives me another angle of attack where if that's... Oh, they also have a mana crypt out, actually. I could do some of that. But yeah, no, I think you're right, Mengu. Also, like, if they deal with my creatures, this can just kill them. They know I have Emrakul, so they actually know it's a big deal. Obviously, they can attack it with the druid, but I don't care too much. So let's see what they've got here. Mm-hmm. Natural Order. Okay. Is this like a Woodfall Primus or something? Like a Progenitus isn't really going to do much. Hey, what's up, Marcus? Oh, I'll come hang with you guys at some point, Marcus. It just hasn't lined up. Each evening I've had to do work because that's just one of the times I tend to be working. So Elder Gargaroth, huh? Okay. That's interesting. I think I'm gonna I don't want to actually get rid of the Mana Crypt, so I think I'm gonna plus and discard Prismatic Vista. Oh, okay, yeah, there we go. Hello, Gargaroth, my old friend. there we go. I think I was fine there anyway, but yeah. All right, well, I'm gonna put in Linvala again. Do I want to take out Force of Will? Yeah, it's. Let's see. I like the Grim. I think if they have Circle of Dreams Druid, the Wrath is going to be good. And I think despite that game, the Season of Hellblade starts aren't really where I want to be. I could put in Frost Titan. I don't think that would be outrageous. Mm-hmm. Did we lose a bet? No, but we're crushing. We're crushing. I might actually take out Show and Tell for Frost Titan here. Because we still have Sneak and Nahiri for this Emrakul. Well, that's probably enough. Hey, what's up, Krager? Welcome, welcome. We didn't lose a bet. We're definitely winning a draft. Yeah, yeah, no, we're doing a thing. We're doing something. Okay. This is the other side of the deck here. Yeah, that is a good point, Billy, where if they natural order for Elder Gargaroth, maybe Show and Tell's not too bad against them. We just ended up in a little bit of a mix of cards here, but I don't like that. Oh, cool. Viewing dungeon information is now like something I can always do here, which is like, I guess they have to put it somewhere and they don't necessarily want to make it so it's only if you have a dungeon, but like, come on. I don't want Needle Spires. Urza's Saga. So I don't think I want Saga here. The reason I don't want Saga is if I play Saga on two, turn three, I still want to play Nahiri with this tomb. So I don't really actually want to do that. And I don't know. It just seemed a little slow here. It doesn't seem like it works. I do like that. Let's go Ponder. Is this good? Nah, this isn't good. I know there's a one toughness creature. Oops. For the Skull Clamp, but I didn't really want the two lands. Do I think the average vintage cube deck could beat an average modern deck? No, not a chance. Not even close. There are some vintage cube decks that could maybe steal some games, but like modern decks are just so good. Kind of wish I kept the Warhound now. It's not actually that big of a deal, but it would have been nice here. The draft was weird for Ondo. It was honestly just a really weird draft. I don't know. Couldn't really explain it to you. Get the lands out of the graveyard. We don't have an Arcanist, so we should keep those. And I think killing their mana dork is better here. Hierarch is newish, yeah. This is the standard cube. Oh, there's a channel. All right, I guess Force Will has to come back in if this is what's going on here. So what are they going to do here? It looks like they're casting maybe like a Green Sun Zenith, but I don't know. We'll see. I assume I'm dead now. Give me another channeling and I have two lands in play. I mean, they did have turn two Acidic Slime, turn three channel. Yeah. This makes Show and Tell a lot worse. Unfortunately, Nahiri can't kill that. I guess I could draw a path. So we're not dead. Let's go Clamp. Equip Clamp. Die. Okay. So given that, I guess we want the Force of Will back in. Still think the Grim is probably fine. Oh, I'll take a Loyal Warhound on the play. At this point, is Skullclamp too weak? We've got Grim, Mother... Yeah, it is too weak. We can't Skullclamp anymore. Fallen Shinobi, I just took out all my creatures, and it's another color, so I'm probably not doing that. You can't play in your main phase be a fun stip? It might be. It seems a little tough, but yeah, you never know. I kind of want to get this Koth in, but I guess I probably don't have enough red. On the other hand, why shouldn't I splash Koth? Actually, hold on. Let me see. I can add a mountain here. All right. Yeah. We'll add another mountain. There we go. Copter, I think, has enough creatures to do this. It's not by much, but I think it's okay. Do I want a Figure of Destiny, I guess, is another question. Or do I want Show and Tell just because I've got... just because I've got a Force of Will? I don't think so. No... Wow, we're really taking out all the creatures. I wonder, is there any chance that I should do something like, it's too late now. I was wondering, maybe I should take out almost everything. All right, I'll keep this. I need to draw a blue or a white mana, but if I do, then I think this hand's going to be pretty good because I've got just these three good white cards, or Thirst can find me more stuff. Plus I have Ancient Tomb to help cast it. So I don't know. No love for the copy draw split card. Now that card seems horrible. This is not really a big mana deck. Ooh. Really? Frost Titan? All right. Channel? Okay. Cool story, bro. I guess it doesn't matter what our draw was or what our changes was. We're just going to get turn two channeled here. Had I drawn the blue card instead of that, maybe we would have got something. Oh, this even looks like an Emrakul. Yeah, this is Emrakul. The Aeon's Tarn. Yeah, if they got it, they got it. Can't do much about that. I mean, turn two channel Emrakuls, you have to have like a Force of Will or like a Force effect or like a discard or you're just dead. There's nothing else you can do. That's just, you got Vintage Cubed, you know? Is how it be sometime. Fire Blast would have done it if I led on Mountain, I suppose. Yes, that is true. What's the secret to good mac and cheese? Good cheese. I do boil the noodles and then drain them and then not quite boil them, but put milk in there and heat it up again with an egg mixed in. And that, I think, adds some good like creaminess to it. All right, here we go. Could you add spinach mac and cheese? Yeah, you can do that. And a lot of things you could add that would be fine. All right. I'm on it. Yes, pre-shredded trees has the like the little starchy stuff on it. That is not great. Ooh, we've got Omnath mana now. Do I want a path? No. Do I want a recruiter? Actually, no. This isn't the best recruiter deck. Ooh, a Loyal Warhound? I do like that. Turn 2, Seasoned Hallowblade. Turn 3, Loyal Warhound. I guess we're giving up the ability to cast Omnath on the next turn, but that's okay. Oh yeah, the Mexican Street Corn is just like, so that the easiness to make versus how good it tastes is, and how like impressive it is a very good ratio. It's a very good value thing to do. Una's Prowler. So we're like Jund Reanimator here. Mm-hmm. Oh, I thought I was going to have to click yes. That was embarrassing. Didn't know how that worked. Damn. Well, okay. Do this, I guess. That was really, really punishing. Okay. I'm just going to discard the Omnath at this point. Power and kill to make me discard a card is a little weird. Okay, okay. Play a land and just going to get Tundra, which I kind of wanted to do anyway. And play a Clamp. Okay. I mean, the Grave Titan, if it's coming out next turn, could be problematic no matter what. And I assume it is, because otherwise you wouldn't discard on 4 mana. Oh, my Azula's talking about Birria tacos. Birria's not intrinsically hipster, but the hipsters have certainly latched onto it. I think that that is an accurate thing to say. Hey, what's up, Eartheye? Welcome back. 7 months. All right, let's hit here. Okay, they don't have makeshift mannequin, but I couldn't really play around it anyway. Let's go Flicker Wisp. Flicker Wisp. This time we're going to get our land here. Oh yeah, the beer is goat. Not pork, yes. Okay. What is going on in a turn? Corpse Dance with buyback? Oh, okay. So they get an Una's Prowler? Sure. Mm-hmm. Hey, Canoxai. 58 months. Welcome back. Welcome back. I do like Flicker Wisp, indeed. Okay, so now they get to Corpse Dance the Grave Titan. This isn't the end of the world. I mean, there is good, but I don't know. They're going to get a bunch of tokens. I'm going to take 8 down to 11, then these two both go away. Hey, no problem, Talented Spore. I'm glad that the NordVPN discount is working for you. So here, they're at 14. Oh. That's a problem. Okay. Let's clamp the Hund. Okay. Let's attack. And clamp the Hallowblade, I guess. Kind of have to draw a blue card. But now the problem is I'm just going to lose to the tokens. And I'm going to bolt a zombie token, I guess. All right. I mean, here we are. Yeah, missing the Loyal Warhound trigger was really bad, obviously. We don't have Dam in our deck. Well, the problem is I need the... I was bolting bed. No, I should have played the Porcelain Legionnaire, actually. No, that was definitely better. The rest card's Corpse Dance. Okay. So they're going to hit me down to 4 here. I assume. Yeah. Right. Yeah, I should have played Porcelain Legionnaire. Oh, no. If I play Porcelain Legionnaire, they attack me with all the tokens. I think that doesn't work out for me. So now... they have... I need to block 3 things with the Hissing Quagmire. Doesn't seem doable to me. Resto and Wisp was bad, yes. Because we just died. I knew they had a hoof here. Okay, that was bad. I don't know that I want Linvala. I don't even know that I want Dam. I guess it does. This is actually a matchup where I feel like I should just be attacking them. I don't have enough disruption to beat like a long-term reanimator deck here. So I don't think that that's the way I want to go. Show and tell's a bit awkward. This isn't a coward stream. Maybe show and tell should be a thing. Mm. Okay, let's play first. Yeah, all right. Let's go turn one, get Tundra, Mox, Porcelain Legionnaire. Turn on Mox is nice. Haven't done that yet. Oh, yee. Fastbond is not a card I typically like in those decks. It doesn't look very good to me. Okay. Hit. And let's go Mother of Runes. I think just pass, leave up Remand. It's not like I'm in a hurry to Remand or to Skullclamp here. Yeah, I thought they might have Vamp. That's why they played the Swamp with the Fastbond out. So I think this is going to be good. I mean, we'll see, though. It would be better if the Vamp leads to, like, a sequence where they have to go, like, throw away multiple cards to make a play. But Remand is not the best if you're not pressuring them. I'm doing okay on pressure, but they're fast enough that maybe they'll be able to survive getting Remanded here. Yeah, Serino, Prowler was the only... I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if they had a few more targets, but Linvala didn't really look that good here. Grist the Hunger Tide. Yeah, and I guess I'll remand it. I don't know. Oh, that was nice. That was a good one. That was potentially a good one. All right, let's send for four. I'm gonna make a slightly greedy play here. Go clamp, equip Mother of Runes because I don't really care too much. And there we go, land. Now we can play Dreadhorde. It also opens the door to maybe playing Omnath next turn. Though right now I need to find a red source that isn't Taiga to play Omnath here. But with a Bolt, I'm pretty close to just killing them with Bolt, right? That puts them to four, and I have 5 points on the board. Obviously, they're going to have a blocker with Grist at the very least, but. And a Tree Speaker, so you mill a card if you put an in, if you mill an insect. They try to make insect decks happen. I don't know about that. Mill the Valky, sure. So the problem with the Bolt plan is they know they're gonna get bolted. So let's just go ahead and lead with Ponder. Ooh, okay. I can play Omnath. Yeah, that's not bad. Let's see. Yeah, Grist is cool. Grist is cool, I think. I don't mind finding Priority. I'm just going to attack them. Cast Ponder here. Hey, what's up, Sir Morik with the 12 months? Actually, can I control Z that? I guess you can't undo that anymore. Well, whatever. I'll just draw Priority. That's fine. Okay. And then I'll go ahead and get my mountain here. Cast Omnath. They said it couldn't be done. All right, I've got some good stuff going. Obviously, they're untapping with like a Grist, but like, look, Fastbond is just, I guess it enabled turn one Vamp, turn two Grist, but I'm really skeptical of Fastbond and decks without draw sevens or maybe like a lot of Coursers type action or trackers, which maybe they do, but. They have 5 mana. All right. They are donezo. Cool. Do I want Linvala now? Because we saw... Well, we saw Valky, that doesn't matter. We saw Jiraga Tree Speaker, which obviously it can do a little bit there. Not like super thrilled about either of those. Maybe this Recruit of the Guard is a bit slow. It's good with Flicker Wisp, but Maybe Grim Lavamancer. Yeah, all right, I kind of like Grim. Grim's a solid little card here. Okay, I'm gonna keep this hand because Arcanist Bolt Grim is pretty nice. This is a little tough because this can get red or white, but I can't get both. I was hoping for a little direction in that sense. Well, I'm gonna get my red mana. Because I'm gonna get Taiga even. Because I've got a bunch of red plays. And if I draw one white land, I can get a second. Hey Abe, what's going on? Brawl grind is good, though I bounce back and forth in terms of rating a lot. Let's just say I think around 4,200 seems to be the point where I most likely am. Whoa, Bitter Blossom? Did not anticipate that. All right, here's show and tell. Oh yeah, we jam it later. Don't you worry. We're jamming later in the stream, and at some point I'll hang out with you guys on Discord and jam too. Oh, Jules. Julie. Good dog, yeah. Yeah, good dog. Mm-hmm. Yep, digging the carpet, dog. That's definitely something good there. Okay. Planes off the top would be nice. Oi. All right. I guess we do nothing. Damn. I don't really think it does anything. To bolt. I could like bolt them. Okay, I guess I'm glad I didn't bolt first. I wouldn't even gotten to do it here. Let's see. Hopefully I don't have something too good, but I don't like where I'm at. Well, they only have three cards in hand. Maybe none of those are good things. Alright, I'm just gonna grim that because I feel like I'm not gonna want to hit them. I have a bolt if they play something small that I need to hit. Oh my god. Okay, well, if I draw planes, at least I can get out of this with the dog. Alright. Planes. Come on, planes. There we go. And this time, I will in fact get my land. Okay. There we go. Let's hope. The thing is, Craterhoof, you can't put in off show and tell and have it really work. So, yeah. Are they going to discard Craterhoof and then Corpse Dance it? Are those last two cards? I will block Acidic Slime for sure. Not like this dog is getting in there anyway. Mm-hmm. After all, why shouldn't I put in an Emrakul? Masker Worm? Psh. Don't care about Masker Worm. Ugh. All right. Mm-hmm. Let's go. Entomb? Okay, they have no cards in hand, so if they're like entombing a Craterhoof, they're just hoping to draw a reanimator spell. And then Emrakul should be just about it here. Hey, later, DC. Have a good one. Boom, boom. Yeah, I wanted to like remove the number of creatures they had in play, but it did work out nicely. Entomb for Ebon Death. Yeah, that's the real strong one. They have no cards in hand, so obviously they could draw something here, but you know, they have to draw something. All right, they entomb the Craterhoof. Go nuts. They're not tapping mana. Attacking doesn't really get them anywhere. Next turn, they're not dead, but it's pretty good. Okay. I mean, I'll block. I don't know. Is there a downside to blocking here? I don't really know. Okay. Yeah, I was just deciding if I wanted to cast Preordain first. But that I don't think is where I want to be. Yeah, they get to. They're not dead. Okay. Well. But. Well, I'll let them figure it out, I guess. They get to sack Blossom for free. Wait, no, they're just dead. They are dead, actually. What do I think? They don't have a blocker. All right. Yeah, there we go. Show and tell did the trick. Well, there we go. 2-1 with an Emrakul Show and Tell White Weenie deck with Omnath as and Dreadhorde Arcanist as little splashes. But yeah, that was great. A fitting end to a sweet draft. Thanks for watching, and check out channelfireball.com for more drafts like this one.